Thank you. Good evening, fans, and welcome to TowneBank Stadium for the USL League Two playoffs. We're in Newport, News, Virginia, with the Charlotte Eagles taking on Lionsbridge FC in the round of 32. Both teams are facing off tonight for a spot in the Eastern Conference semifinals. That'll take place Sunday at 7:30 against North Carolina Fusion here at TowneBank Stadium. But before then, we have to see who will join the Fusion there between the Eagles and Lionsbridge. Charlotte Eagles and Lionsbridge, two teams that have played each other before. That was back in 2018, back in the inaugural season for Lionsbridge. Things ended up going the way of the bridge in that second meeting. Lionsbridge came away with a 2-1 victory in that first meeting, though both teams battled it out to a 0-0 draw. So in the third match between Lionsbridge and Charlotte, we'll see who comes out on top during the USL 2 playoffs. Charlotte Eagles, an overall record of 9-2-3 and 30 points in the South Atlantic Division. They finished second in the table, just behind North Carolina Fusion. So of course they'd love to get a bit of retribution on their division rivals. Throughout this season, they've scored 38 goals for, and they've been scored on just 21 times. Currently two games in the win column in a row. A 2-0 victory versus Wake FC, and of course a 1-0 victory throughout the season against Tobacco Road. Start things off here with the ball. We're going to get with the lineups. Number 1, Matt Levy. Number 3, Bryce Swinehart. Number 7, Elijah John. Number 8, Martin Gravecamp. Number 9, Simone Afrifa. Number 11, Oscar Carvalho. Number 15, Theo Drennan. Number 16, Dominic De Almeida. Number 23, Juan Wabisi Mbibisa. Number 24, Joshua Erlandson. Number 29, Carter Hensley. And on the other side of the field, it's Lionsbridge FC wearing those blue and white uniforms. Charlotte Eagles in the navy on the left side. So the bridge with a record of 9-2-1 here in the Chesapeake Division. They won the division outright in the top of the table. Just behind them is Northern Virginia FC, who did not make it into the playoffs. Lionsbridge, the lone representative for the Chesapeake Division here in the USL 2 postseason. He's getting it off underway. First foul goes over to Lionsbridge, an inadvertent handball. It'll cause a brief pause in the action before it's quickly restarted by John. Passing it over to Swinehart. That Lionsbridge lineup over to you in just a moment. It's the second year in a row where Lionsbridge FC are the Chesapeake Division champions. They made it to the playoffs last year as well, but got bounced out in the first round by Vermont Green FC. Vermont Green not in the playoffs this year. The Charlotte Eagles standing in their way and very nearly the opener for the Eagles. There's Dominic De Almeida and real close to Tyler Hogan, who's starting it off in between the pipes for Lionsbridge. The team captain, of course, number 31, Sam Hall. Number 3, George Wyatt in defense. Defender number 5, David Materazzi. In the midfield, it's number 6 and number 7. That's Andrew Bennett and Josh Baker, respectively. Number 9, Isaiah Chisholm sets his feet up top in the forward position. Next to him is number 10, Matty Cornish, also a forward. Harry Rowe, another one of the defenders. He's wearing number 19 this evening. Also a defender is number 21, Adam Kirkwood. And rounding out the squad is number 29, Christian Hatley. As this one makes its way just past Rowe. That was in that left back position. All the way back with Hogan, who holds on to it. Just waiting for pressure to come his way as he pushes the team forward. Rowe listed as a defender, but typically we see him play more of a wing back style of soccer. As ball skips up Hatley. He's able to control it though. Fires from distance, just touched to the side it looked like, but Levy didn't even need to make a save there. It's the opening shot for Lionsbridge, just goes wide of the target. And Now Charlotte forced to come out of their own territory. Deep within their own 18. Hatley, high pressure coming. Getting physical with Erlinson over in that left back position. Erlinson can't win the battle. The ball goes out of bounds, throwing for Lionsbridge. Another chance at a solid possession, possibly trying to test the goalkeeper. Hall trying to control it, but it's Erlinson who gets the pass away. Hard challenge on Carvalho. Lionsbridge gets called for a foul. Good sportsmanship coming from Baker. Just checking in on the player. Letting him know that there was no bad intent from the foul. It's already in the previous game that was played here tonight between North Carolina Fusion and Western Mass Pioneers. Fusion ended up winning that game by a score of 2-1. We already had our first goal in the first game. It was the Fusion who scored in just the second minute. Lionsbridge, typically a team that we've seen in previous years. Similar tactics where they look to get out early and try and jump on the scoreboard within the first 10 minutes. Did last time out with a goal from Isaiah Chisholm. He's positioned up top. He's been on a nice streak of form recently. Him and Matty Cornish. Been on top of their game. In that four-game win streak for Lionsbridge. Before that four-game win streak, they only had just one win. I believe it was five games in the month of June. And that first win, and only win, came June 3rd against Virginia Beach United. And after that, it was a pair of draws and a pair of losses, if I'm not mistaken, as Hatley is battling with Erlinson over on the far side of the field. That's certainly going to be a matchup I'm excited to watch here tonight. Hatley with a lot of speed. Pass over to Bennett. Baker cutting it out. Hall firing this one just over the crossbar. Good pressure from Lionsbridge, but still nothing yet to test Matt Levy in goal. There'll be hydration breaks here in this evening contest. Charlotte looks to come out of their own territory. Good pass from Gravecamp. Progress down the field. Baker sliding tackle. Disrupts the play. Wins the ball back for his side. Tries to find Chisholm up top. Turned away by the Eagles. John sends it back into the defense. He gets it back. Elijah John surveys. Tries to send the ball up. Hit it away by Wyatt. Right place at the right time for Carvalho. Tries to use a little bit of fancy footwork to free up some space. Baker able to close him down though. And the Eagles will get whistled for their first foul of the contest. Despite having five players in the lineup penciled in as defenders, it's more like Lionsbridge likes to play with a back three and then have two wingbacks help out with the midfield and the attack. Bit of a false five of sorts along the back line for the Bridge. I mentioned earlier that Charlotte has yet to win here at TowneBank Stadium, or Kamoko Stadium as it was called at the time, back in 2018. Only played one game here in Newport News. Good work to move up the field for the Eagles. Materazzi able to nudge it just out of bounds, having one step on the forward. Well, as Hensley tried to outpace Materazzi, unable to do so, although trying to make himself available for a throw-in. Instead, this one makes its way inside of the 18, settled down by Swinehart. It's moved over to Gravekamp. Outside of the box for now, still a bit of ways to go for the Eagles. Lionsbridge trying to bring the pressure, though. I like to see this from Charlotte. Content to just play the possession game. They don't see something that they like immediately. They're more than happy to bring the ball back into their defense, try and get a second, maybe even third look at things. Ball makes its way back once more over to Theo Drennan. And wait for the perfect opportunity to go forward. The only issue with that is that sometimes that perfect opportunity doesn't quite show up. Eventually, you will have to just make something happen. Until we get to that stage, Charlotte limiting the chances that Lionsbridge could have going forward when Lionsbridge doesn't even have the ball. In the end, though, it's an unforced error that turns the ball over. Hogan swings his foot through this one to Chisholm. And it gets headed back to Matt Levy. A short pass back out. Turning over to John. Now Hensley. Hard pass down the line. De Almeida has this one taken off his foot by Hogan. Good awareness by Hogan and a good run by the Eagles, specifically De Almeida. Chisholm chests it down to Hatley. Defender comes in. It's Joshua Erlinson again. That matchup over on that far side of the field. Hatley and Erlinson battling it out so far here this evening. Just past the center line. Cut down by the Eagles, but Lionsbridge able to win the ball back. That's Cornish. Out for Hatley. Good control by the winger. Has Cornish on an overlapping run and is able to feed him, but the ball outpaces Cornish. A bit too much power as it sailed out over the sideline. Lionsbridge gets a second chance at things. Squandered that opportunity. Flicked on by Carballo. And Bibisa can't keep it in play. The ball forward was offsides. Excuse me, Bibisa able to keep it in play, but subsequent pass was offsides. Levy finally picks it up. John sending it over to Erlinson. Hall with a little bit of pressure, can't cut off the passing lane entirely. It gets up to Simon Afrifa. Chisholm to Hall. Picked up by Cornish to recover the play. Rowe up to Chisholm on the edge of the box, knocked down by Kirkwood. Hatley keeps it with his feet inside the 18. Chisholm can't bury it inside the 6-yard box. He sends it up and over the bar in the 12th minute. Lionsbridge thought they had the opener. It's the second time in 2 games Chisholm has been in a picture perfect spot to tuck the ball into the goal. Ends up with a goal kick. We certainly do admire that, though, from Chisholm and Lionsbridge as a home side supporter. Showing chances created but just can't convert yet here at TowneBank Stadium. Ball trying to be lifted just past Materazzi. Able to utilize his larger body to get the step on the forward. And played out to Cornish. Has to race down the line, thinks twice about it. And knocked out of bounds off the Almeida's foot. Afrifa playing that forward position for the Charlotte Eagles. It's all turned towards the middle, but it's all taken off his foot. Afrifa, the target man, which we've seen already played a couple times. Once he was offsides. We'll see if he can just play that defensive line just a little bit better. There's no doubt. Look to try and feed him one more time at least. Give and go by Hensley. Charlotte able to stay in possession. Foul by Chisholm. And Swinehart goes down. Free kick for the visitors here tonight. A round of 32 USL 2 playoffs in the Eastern Conference. Baker over to Cornish, trying to use his speed. Creates a bit of separation. Sends it over to Chisholm inside the box. The battle inside the 18. The ball just rolls to the goalkeeper, Levy. Good effort with Drennen, though. As Drennen gets some knuckles from Levy. Did well to battle with Chisholm the entire way there. And Gubisa dispossessed. Charlotte has the ball back. De Almeida on the right wing. Plenty of space for him. Sends a low ball. Carvalho's effort is cleared away. This one rolling, bouncing out towards the sideline. Throw in by Charlotte. They look to take their time going forward again. Good pass up to Carvalho. He's brought down. By Cornish. That's another foul for Lionsbridge. So Charlotte with the free kick. Looks like De Almeida will take this one. Likely just played short to Swinehart. It's a short pass indeed. John able to switch it over to Erlinson though. That might open up the field here on the near side for De Almeida. Try to go through the middle. Materazzi able to get the step. Chisholm out wide for Hatley and Lionsbridge with a counterattack opportunity. Chisholm in towards the middle, but Hatley's just knocked out of bounds for a corner kick. Lionsbridge with a corner attempt coming up. Materazzi, Chisholm, and Hall all inside the 18. Kirkwood makes his way there as well. Cornish just on the edge of the box. Right, Bennett over by the corner. Make anything out of this chance. 17th minute. Corner service is sent in towards the middle. Levy comes down with the ball. That's such an important grab for the Eagles that he holds on to it. And now a quick counterattack coming, possibly. Carvalho dribbling. Cornish trying to shut him down. Wyatt can't get there in time, and it's played right to Hogan. Hogan with an easy grab. And also gets a little bit of a time off to Cornish. Lionsbridge nearly caught on the back foot. The Eagles unable to convert on their attempt. Materazzi rolling the ball forward. Overpasses Chisholm. And the Eagles will start things again. De Almeida will pass to Swinehart. And the defense once again. And the patience beginning to take place once more by Charlotte. Surveying the field, just looking for that great opportunity to get the ball forward. They think they have it here. Nice turn attempted by Afrifa. And no one there to follow up with him. Now Hogan will pick it up, pull it out to Kirkwood. Jalon doing a nice job closing down those immediate passing lanes, forcing Kirkwood to go the distance to try and link up with Chisholm. When you eliminate those ground passes, it makes it much more risky to try and deliver the ball upfield. Gives midfielders and defenders time to position themselves as Hall goes in for a sliding effort, he gets stepped on. As he tried to poke the ball over to a teammate. Simple call for the referee. Play resumes once more. Materazzi sends it all the way back to Hogan, and now with Kirkwood. Sam Hall, of course, the team captain for Lionsbridge's pass from Rowe. A bit awkward there. Kirkwood able to deal with it. Chested down by Chisholm. Hatley has it stuck under his feet. It's taken away by Charlotte. De Almeida gives the pass over to Elijah John. Again, just waiting for the chance to go forward. Is Charlotte. Nice give and go, but Kirkwood steps up to answer the bell. Cornish takes it up in the middle of the field. Sends it back into his own defense now. Rowe. Pass to Bennett. And he'll settle down once more. As Cornish has his feet firmly planted along the touchline. They're in front of the fans. De Almeida in the vicinity, though, to try and mark him. Bennett spots him. The Hall plays a pass up. Cornish taking a touch. Second one. Rose behind him. He drops it for Baker, firing. A good save by Levy. Goalkeeper to the track that one the whole way. Did well to hold on to it. Swinehart goes up the field. Kirkwood able to make the interception. Rowe along the sideline. And both teams being extra cautious, trying to make sure that they have good avenue to go forward. De Almeida putting the pressure on. Kirkwood forced to get rid of it quickly. Entourage with a big touch out in front of him, but he has the room. He sends it up to Hatley, who's offsides. Just getting the timing a bit wrong on his run. That effort all for naught. So free kick comes up for the Eagles. The team captain for Lionsbridge, but it almost seems like Materazzi is a captain of sorts in the defense for the Bridge as well. You see, he often is pointing things out towards his teammates, making sure everyone's covered up in their proper positions. Laid up on the edge of the box. Chisholm can't win the header. The Eagles recover in the starting attack of their own. De Almeida, along the sideline, receives the pass. Carvalho's making his way down the line as well. Instead, it goes back into the defense. All doing quite a bit of work to try and track the ball down. De Almeida goes up and over Rowe. Free kick gets called against De Almeida. Just the third foul of the half for Charlotte. Four for Lionsbridge here in the 24th minute. Edward boots the ball up, trying to link up with Chisholm. Send Hall inside the 18, but good shielding by Swinehart, allowing Levy to make a claim to it. The possession continues for the Eagles. Swinehart touches it out in front of him, pass through the center of the field with a dangerous idea with so many light blue jerseys in the area. Elijah John gets called for a foul. So it was Baker he brought down. Excuse me, Bennett. It's Hatley. Able to control it over on the far sideline. Hensley needs to get the ball out of there as there was a tangle of legs between Hensley and Baker this time. Free kick with pretty good field position for Lionsbridge. Have a couple players making their way towards the edge of the box. This time, Cornish is drawn back in towards the defense. On a repeat of last time where they're basically gifted a pass right into Hogan's chest as the ball is played up. Eddie comes down with it. No real pressure, and that's the big downside of playing those high lofted balls inside the 18. Gives the goalkeeper plenty of time to try and get under the ball. Time is jumped perfectly. Take it away from the opposition. Bennett over to Hatley. Can he keep it in bounds? Linesman says he does. Service in towards the back post. Cornish has to get on his horse and track this one down. Rolls out of play. Throw in for the visitors. Swinehart, great throw. Get up to Carvalho. Carvalho battling along the sideline with Rowe. Throwing doesn't go his way though. Just a brief slowdown for Kirkwood to retie his boot. Cornish settling it down. Edge of the box. Drops it back to Hatley. Left-footed effort. Up to Chisholm. Inside the 18. Can he make anything happen? Two defenders close him down. Hall tries to keep the play alive. And the Eagles able to hold off that last effort by Lionsbridge. Somehow it seems like by the skin of their teeth, without even managing Lionsbridge. Not even Lionsbridge managing to get a shot off on target. Let alone a shot in general. It was very nearly about to spell disaster for them. Good pressure along the near side of the box. They close down Lionsbridge winger. Now you see Hatley and Cornish almost switching sides on the field. Hatley now on the near side. Where's the bottom of your screen, Cornish up top. Talking about that battle earlier between Erlinson and Hatley. We'll see how Hatley matches up against Swinehart. Gubisa asking for the ball. He gets it. Goes along the touchline. Drops it back to Swinehart. Now it's played forward. Hensley, miscommunication with a teammate. Ball sails through. 28 minutes gone by. That first hydration break just around the corner, I presume. Chisholm. Dropping it down to himself. Baker out to Cornish along the wing. Step over. Creates some space. Pass Gravekamp. Hall gets it now. Chisholm in towards the middle. That ball too far out in front of him, and Levy makes the claim again. Levy doing a really nice job. Staying extra vigilant along the goal line. Using his judgment especially well whether or not to step forward. Speaking of stepping up to things, nice job by Baker. A good challenge. Pokes the ball away, allows Materazzi to just knock it out of bounds for another throw-in. Pressure coming for Gravekamp. Gets the ball off his foot. It's just deep into Lionsbridge territory. Hogan will send it back out wide. Kirkwood had to hustle to get on the end of it, but he did there and made it there. Oh, giving it back to him. Now Materazzi. Really trying to utilize the full width of the field, Lionsbridge is. Cornish takes it, plays the way he faces. The ball finds its way to Hatley. Rowe, an overlapping run. Hatley cuts towards the center, looking for that far post. The ball just turning away at the last moment. A sound strike on the ball, just couldn't quite wrap his foot around it enough. And that's where we go into our hydration break. In the 30th minute, a fair number of chances created by Lionsbridge. Not many though for the Eagles. They've still had quite a few opportunities to carry the ball down into the attacking third for Lionsbridge. Tested Hogan once or twice, but nothing too significant as to make him really be forced to make a big save. Only really one play that comes to mind, Dominic De Almeida. And a quick counterattack. Seemed like Cornish couldn't get there to slow down De Almeida in time. In the end, De Almeida just played it right into Hogan's chest. Almost like you'd see a goalkeeper in there warming up. Visitors starting things quickly as Carvalho has it. It's back into the defense. Starting the action again with a quick goal kick. Maybe trying to catch Lionsbridge a bit unaware. As Hall moves over to try and close down passing lanes. Rowe. Hafrifa gets the ball back from Carvalho, taking it towards the corner. Materazzi and Rowe trying to close him down. Good step by Hatley. poking the ball out of bounds. De Almeida with the throw. The ball shakes off one defender. Kirkwood heads it away outside of the 18. Charlotte regroups. Opening here for Carballo. Touched away by Materazzi with his heel. The second chance. Anguissa inside the box, firing a low shot. Hogan had that one covered, but it didn't even make it to him. Second chance is turned away. Out of bounds for just a throw-in. It's interesting to see Lionsbridge sort of adapt to the same play style that Charlotte has been having when it comes to the possession game. See Charlotte multiple times, almost every time it seems, start the attack from their defense. Whenever they get the ball, as Chisholm gets a step on the defender. Swinehart trying to close him down inside the box, firing this one just wide of the post. Again, Chisholm with a golden opportunity, but he can't convert. Opting to place it perfectly in the corner, coming up empty. The home side thought they had it. It's a great move by Chisholm along the center line. Feeling that he'd step forward to take the ball, instead letting it roll past him, past the defender as well. And Divisa, three blue jerseys to try and close him down. Heads it between them. Hogan punches it down in front of him. Crisis averted there for Lionsbridge, and now they're back on the counter once again. Hatley gets outpaced by Carballo. Lionsbridge fortunate to walk away from there unscathed. Now slowing things down. The Eagles again, as I mentioned just a moment ago, bringing the ball into their defense. Just waiting for their time to go forward. Swinehart, one of the defenders with so many touches this game so far here inside the first half. Carballo making his way towards the middle, firing off a cross, but foul called. Kirkwood will just pass it over to Materazzi. So Hatley's still on the near side of the field. Cornish moved over up top. Excuse me, up to the top side. Chisholm playing the target man. Rowe feeds Hatley. They'll say the ball went out of bounds, though. Fans not happy with that one. Linesman just standing right on the line. The best angle of that pass. Perhaps Charlotte changing things up, trying to move quickly. Maybe a bit of miscommunication between him and Gravekamp. Pass goes up and over to Hatley. He's on the edge of the 18. Skips past the defender. He's brought down, and the home side lands a foul. I assume the referee is thinking that there was no way Hatley would be able to get to the ball anyway. A conversation with the official. Well, Rowe has the throw in. Trying to find Chisholm. Setting it down. Nice touch. Hatley touches it over Chisholm, bringing it towards the corner. It's shielded out of play by Drennan. good defensive mind by Drennan not to try and take the ball out of his own territory, just instead let it roll out for a goal kick. De Almeida trying to make a run in through the Lionsbridge defense. The pass didn't come his way. Carballo gets set. Swinehart instead goes over to Elijah John. Hensley has the ball ping off his foot. Now it's with Carballo by himself, headed by Rowe. Seems like a dangerous play. Hogan has it safely in his hands. Kirkwood and Materazzi. Right around 10 minutes to go if you include stoppage time here in the first half. No official word yet, but probably a couple minutes. It's headed out of bounds by Swinehart. That's certainly not what he was trying to do. He'll bring up a second. A corner kick, though. Four lines, which will be their third of this contest. What a chance this could be just before halftime. Fusion scored in the stoppage time of the 45th minute in the game earlier. Bennett crossed towards the back post. Materazzi goes down. Wanted a call to go his way as he was brought down. I think that's the right call by the official. There's not enough contact inside the box. Warrant a foul. Big challenge by Bennett. Knocked the ball out of play. Slows down the attack. Gives the players just more time to drop back into their own territory. Get set up. A good step makes his way past two line switch defenders before Materazzi has to shut things down. Another throw in for the Eagles. Andy Visa offsides currently, now back on. Place the ball over to Erlinson. Intent to sit with the ball are the Eagles. We'll swing it around the defense. And now try and step things forward. And Givisa is upended. Turnover. Hall in a 2-on-1. Nearly gets kicked there and he's brought down. Foul. To Bennett, gives it back to him. Now Materazzi with the pressure coming his way, gets it off his foot, but fires it right to John. A free foot. Ball gets played over towards the corner. Hogan will reel it back in. Second minute. Both teams trying to ensure that they don't go down one before halftime as Chisholm trying to get on the end of this one inside the box. He gets called for a foul. But Drennan shields the ball again. Just telling Chisholm to settle down just a little bit. They've still got plenty of time left in this game. The chances will come. Certainly don't want a player like Chisholm find himself in a tricky situation as we saw in the earlier game where Khalid Rose came up out onto the field in the 63rd minute for Western Mass Pioneers. In that same minute, ended up getting a yellow card. And 20 minutes later, picked up his second yellow to put his side down a man as Marbalo sends him a ball and very dangerous opportunity. Afrifa almost rooted to his spot. Wasn't quite sure, it seemed like he knew what he had in that chance as Atley, a good touch to settle the ball down. Has Rowe behind him, and Bennett as well. Bennett plays it over to Cornish. Defender spied that one from a mile away. Erlingson, great eyes to pick that pass out. Much power behind the pass. Goes out along the sideline. Rowe with the throw in. Baker has this one skip out in front of him. Afrifa. Traversing across the width of the field. Lays it off Carvalho. Great positioning, but he can't convert as he plays that ball up and over the bar. Pass over to Kirkwood. Lionsbridge playing a slow game here once again inside their own defense. Materazzi waiting for a chance to go forward, links up with Hall. Akers passes off the mark and it's picked off by John. Now the Eagles try and get things going here just before the announcement of stoppage time. Pass knocked down at least, not quite intercepted though for Lionsbridge. Charlotte with another chance to go forward. Swinehart. Hensley. Well, to avoid those challenges, Carvalho can't get on the end of his pass. Kirkwood keeps it in play, knocking it off De Almeida for a Lionsbridge throw. And with 2 minutes of stoppage time, as Hall catches the ball and sends it right back to Rowe. De Almeida still pleading his case to the official. Kirkwood sends it over to Materazzi. There's plenty of space. He brings it up the field. It's intercepted. And then Gibisa. Pass over to Carvalho. All a little bit of a push. Fortunate not to give away a foul there. The Eagles will settle things down. They continue to work their way up the field slowly but surely. Swinehart gets the pass off his foot. He was well inside Lionsbridge territory. That's the game plan for Charlotte. If no pressure really comes their way and they have the ball in the defense, why not just take the free space as Lionsbridge goes forward. Hatley settling it down. Has Rowe on his left. Able to find him. Rowe, cross in towards the middle. Out of bounds for a corner. Levy trying to pull everyone back now here as Lionsbridge gets set for another corner. The right idea from Levy. The 45th minute stoppage time. We won't see too much play after this corner. Bennett and a free kick. Towards Materazzi. It's headed away by one of the defenders. And that's where we go into the halftime break. Level 0-0, 0-0 apiece. In the USL 2 playoffs, round of 32, a spot in Sunday night's matchup. The Eastern Conference semifinals against NC Fusion on the line. Still nothing to split these two teams. We're going to take a brief break and be right back in about 15 minutes for the second half coming up.
Bearing through the affected bone. Sometimes that may require crutches, bracing, or casting. Then as the pain starts to get better, you can slowly start to incorporate cross-training with it and physical therapy to help correct any type of underlying muscular imbalances or biomechanical errors to take pressure off of the bone.
Hoops, they're everywhere, especially when it comes to banking. Lots of banks offer you big promises with their checking accounts, but there's always a hoop to jump through. At Langley, we don't like hoops. Our smart checking offers great features like getting your paycheck up to 3 days early, no monthly fees, and no minimum balances. No hoops, just straightforward banking with Langley. Open your smart checking account today.
As soon as you arrive, you'll see it in the people you meet and the way we follow through. At Bowditch Ford, your dealership experience will be one of total satisfaction. Our professional sales associates make buying easy, fast, and fun. And when it comes to service, experience better. From maintenance to repair to parts, collision, even our quick lane, we do it better. Your time is valuable and your dollars hard-earned. We'll take care of you. Bowditch Ford, a tradition of doing the right thing.
A yard without mosquitoes is always the most popular yard in the neighborhood.
They're home! Scatter!
Homeowners, consider yourselves warned.
Again?
Mosquito Joe, outside is fun again.
Great vision and healthy eyes are the goal at Peninsula Eye Care. Optometrists diagnose and treat many disorders of the eye and visual system and are a great addition to your healthcare team. We prescribe glasses, contact lenses, and medications to serve you. I'm Dr. David Buck, and if you're looking for a team that will care about you and is ready to listen, come see us at Peninsula Eye Care.
Now this is the best idea ever. The all-new Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla from Papa John's. We put the bold flavors of Doritos Cool Ranch all over our signature flatbread-style sandwich and created the zestiest flavor mashup ever. Oh, and some Doritos Cool Ranch dipping sauce? We thought of that, too. Get the new Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla before it's gone. Only at Papa John's.
Thank you.
In life, some things just go together, like a burger and fries, and home and auto insurance from State Farm. Combine and save.
In Newport News, talk to State Farm agent Jimmy Fay today.
Got another 45 minutes on the clock. The Eagles and Lionsbridge still deadlocked at zero in the round of 32, the first round of the USL 2 playoffs. The Eastern Conference spot in the semifinals against North Carolina Fusion awaits the winner of this match. That game taking place just a couple days away, July 23rd, Sunday at 7 o'clock p.m. will take place here as well at TowneBank Stadium. Eagles have had a couple good chances so far to try and test Hogan, though nothing really too dangerous for him. Is it's been a little bit different though for Matt Levy, who's had to be on his guard a couple of times dealing with the four corner kicks that Lionsbridge had. Of course, the additional shots from the run of play, the two big chances that Lionsbridge had, both going over to Isaiah Chisholm. Levy wasn't tested at all. We'll see if Lionsbridge can sort of hone in their sights a little bit as Chisholm tries to get on the end of this ball played up inside the 18 from Wyatt. Levy comes out and claims it. No trouble at all. Throughout the first half, there was really patient style of play from the Eagles. Charlotte more than content to have the ball inside their own half, and around their defense as they slowly worked up towards that center side, towards that center circle, crossing over that center line, waiting for a good chance to go forward to try and eliminate a number of Lionsbridge players as the ball goes out for a corner. The first of the contest for the Eagles. They had none in the first half. Moving over to take this one is Elijah John. Baker just took a little bit of a knock on his ankle. He moves towards that front post as he's just trying to get a little bit of motion inside his ankle so he can work it out. John with the corner, swinging away from the goalkeeper, just wide of the full mouth attempt there by Swinehart. A bit of danger there for Hogan and the Lionsbridge roster. Again, nothing really connecting, testing either of these two goalkeepers. A short pass back to Kirkwood. Materazzi sends it up to Hatley, keeps it in play. Both teams fighting for possession. Hall, short pass to Bennett. Still inbounds for Lionsbridge. Chisholm taking it towards the corner. They make its way back towards the middle. Play on from the official. Baker just running out of steam, it seems like. Wonder if that's the ankle that's bothering him just a little bit, prevented him from getting up to full speed. Or it's just the wear and the physicality from this game in the first half. Must be overexerted himself just a bit too much. Doesn't have much left in the tank. Stepping over the ball, allowing this one to roll right to Materazzi. Pulling it out of bounds, throwing for Charlotte. Frifa has to keep the ball in play and does so. Great to Materazzi though, as Hensley was trying to go forward. His way in past the defense. Still on that right side of the formation that we see on the bottom of your screen. Heels along the touchline as he's headed back up top towards Hatley. Stepping forward, gets it out to Cornish. Edge of the box. Two defenders coming to close him down. Lots the pass off to Bennett. Cornish gets it back. Can he get a cross in now? Steps over. Hatley has this one taken away from his foot. Hachirazi, a big step. Mobalo goes down. Hachirazi will get a yellow card. Call for a late challenge, possibly on Machirazzi. There were a couple players appealing for a handball. I think it was just for the late challenge. Sent Carvalho to the ground. Erlinson will have to battle it out with Cornish. He's now here. Chisholm makes his way towards the corner. There's a little bit of support coming his way. Hall picks up the pass inside the 18 now. Towards the middle. Now the end line across the center. And another missed chance for Lionsbridge as Hatley couldn't convert. Three golden opportunities for the Bridge, and not a single one resulting in a shot on target. Two for Chisholm and one for Hatley. Free kick for the Eagles. Another foul goes against Lionsbridge. That one started a bit too early. I think that'll ultimately favor Charlotte. That pass was off the mark. I don't think Mongibiso is going to be able to get on the end of it. He's once again situated edge of the formation. Now Lionsbridge comes over to try and shut him down. Pass over to Carvalho. Hard challenge by Bennett. Can't take the ball away, though. Kirkwood gives it away from the 18-yard box. Recovered by the Eagles. They get set to do it again. Carvalho again. Gets past Cornish. Drops the ball back to Swinehart on the far side of the field. Cross up and inside the 18. Wyatt sees this one roll by him. Looks to clear it up to Cornish. Pressure coming from behind. Erlinson. Chisel down to Hall. He looks to give it back to Chisel. Out pace the defender. Fires this one home. Again, as a player over on the far side of the field. Well, just a little bit early. Previously, they were content to have the ball and sit back with it inside their own half, but now trailing by one. You would think that they'd have to change the plan, and it looks like they have. Carvalho going to pass it up to Mongibiso. That pass outpaces him, out for a goal kick. Isaiah Chisholm, three goals in three games. Goal kick coming up for Hogan. Let's the ball fly. De Almeida trying to head it back up for Alfufa. Kirkwood able to knock it up the field, out of bounds for a throw-in. Lionsbridge retain possession. There's De Almeida able to knock the ball down out of play. Bennett sends it all the way over to Cornish. Gets a gift wrap to him by Erlinson. 2-on-1, Cornish still with the ball. Out in towards the end line, back inside. Goes all the way through, too much power behind it. Nifty move, but man, that ball got away from him quite a bit. Sped up by a little bit. John. Just past Chisholm. Doesn't put too much effort trying to chase him down. Mainly about closing down those passing angles. The Swinehart gets fouled. The chance to be careful of giving away too many fouls is seen it in the past come back to bite them. Away just too many free kicks inside their own half, too many good chances that teams love to convert on. And Gibisa battling with Wyatt. The former earns himself, rather his team, a throw-in. Erlinson with the throw. Theo Drennan sends across towards the backside of the box. It up and out of bounds, a corner kick coming up for the Eagles. A chance to equalize here in the 57th minute. Lionsbridge pulling all their players back now. Fired by Swinehart, wrapped up by Hogan. Not as much power behind that last header from Swinehart. Didn't get the connection he wanted, like on that previous corner. Only two corners so far for the Eagles. Both of them able to find Bryce Swinehart. First one could have been quite a dangerous effort had it been on target. Like there might just be something up with that goal down on the left side of the field. A couple of chances missed in the first half by Lionsbridge, and now we see a couple efforts go wide for the Eagles as well. Heavy has this ball safely at his feet. Just a little nudge over to a teammate as the Eagles try and work their way up the field. A little bit more urgency, but not quite desperation yet. That's the big difference. And a lot of teams can't quite walk that fine line. Free kick for Lionsbridge. We saw that in the first game between Western Mass and the Fusion. Therefore, Western Mass Pioneers, it looked like quite able to turn up the tempo to the urgency setting, so to speak, and went right to desperation, down by two. And with that, it just comes trying to overforce everything. It's Baker able to take the ball away from Afrifa, picking up a free kick in the process. It's good tempered aggression coming from the Eagles, knowing they have a job to do. Now they're just trying to execute on it. Now they're not quite impatient. You can still see that increase in speed and play. They're almost always looking to keep the ball in motion, whereas in the first half they were content to stand with the ball not moving in their defense, waiting for Lionsbridge to move up the field or drop further back to open up some space across the pitch. Wyatt with a throw, helped on by Bennett, but it's over the opposition. De Almeida pass over to Gravekamp through the middle of the field. And Gibisa in towards the center. Afrifa looked like he was offsides. Linesman flag is up. Third minutes left in regulation. Lionsbridge up by one. The goal just about 8 minutes ago from Chisholm. Yellow card issued to Tyler Hogan. He'll be the first player to go into the referee's book this evening. Chisholm puts it along, trying to get it up to Hatley. Heavy off his line. Puts the ball back out quickly. He's going to play it to himself, but too far out in front. And again, Eagles on the attack. Going to find their way through the middle of the field, disrupted by Hall. So they're forced to drop back a little bit. Gravekamp gets the ball. Shuffles it out to Erlinson. Not a lot of movement going on for Erlinson. Brennen will try and get the ball back across the width of the field towards the far side in front of the Eagles bench. That's where it stands now. Juan Divisa inside the box, firing past Hogan, but past the post as well. And you see, that's certainly when that patience is paying off. They didn't see anything on the near side of the field in front of the fans. And whereas desperation mode, it seems like you would just try and push through that, force something to work. Eagles took a moment, assessed the situation, brought the ball over to the opposite side, tried to start something. You know, they had a bit more success. Played up to Hatley, he's on sides, but no way can he get to that ball. Drennan slowly bringing it up over to Swinehart. He was along the touchline, he was keep it going. Drift back into their own half, and you see the blue and white jerseys slowly moving over to watch the ball as well. Bennett picking it up in the middle of the field. Now it's back with Rowe. Materazzi sitting with Hogan. He can take his time here as Afrifa is forced to come and pressure him. Materazzi sends it down into the opposite end. Chisholm can't settle it. And it goes out of bounds for a Charlotte throw-in. Played out of bounds by Swinehart as Chisholm is down on the field and being helped out by Gravekamp. See a couple substitutions, at least one, come out onto the field for Lionsbridge. see Josh Baker coming out of the game, as well as Hatley. And into the game, Lockie Foley. And Daniel Salome as well coming out onto the field to take the place of Hatley and Baker. See if there's a substitution for Chisholm as he makes his way off the field along the near side, walking by the festival area. Seems like for now, Lionsbridge is looking to play with 10 men. Don't know word yet on if another substitute will come into the game. Now it looks like there's a substitute ready for Lionsbridge. Play restarts for the Eagles and certainly want to make the most of this. Opportunity, Lionsbridge down a player. The pending substitution. Ball rolls out of bounds. They get set for the throw-in. Looks like it might be Dakota Yonke coming in. Yes, we're getting word. It is confirmation Yonke comes into the game. Holding a man up top for the Bridge. Placing Chisel. Chisel, the one goal scorer for now in this contest, 52nd minute. That's been the difference maker so far. Troy is certainly not out of this contest by any means. So we've been able to build up a couple chances. And Dubisa dropping it off to Afrifa. Cross in towards the middle. Just pushed over the bar by Hogan. There'll be another corner kick coming up. Three corners here in the second half for Charlotte. None for Lionsbridge. A role reversal from the first half when Lionsbridge had four and the Eagles had none. Service is sent towards the penalty spot. Salome can't get there. Charlotte recovers. Gravekamp out wide for Carballo. In towards the middle. It's up with Yonke. He can't control it. Gravekamp able to take it, settle things down, get it over to Drennan. So rinse and repeat here for the Eagles. All played up outside of the reach of Carballo. It's just headed out of play. A substitute gets ready for the Eagles. Play continues as Carballo takes this one towards the center of the field. Swinehart takes it in stride and gives it off to John. Free kick for Lionsbridge. They thought they had advantage going forward. The play gets brought back. And a yellow card issued to a Charlotte player. And the 69th minute. Afrifa coming out of the game. Carlos Cristales coming in. Offsides with the call. On the other end of the field. And it looks like that was a yellow card for Hensley. Medusa can't keep the ball in play. Ball just too far out in front of him. Lionsbridge has a throw inside their own half. Flipped on up for Yonke. Trying to get around the defender. But Theo Drennan, again, just proving to be a dominant force in the back line for the Eagles. He's done a really nice job effectively using his body to shield the ball, let it either roll out of play or pick up a foul from it. As Faye goes down, awkward clash there. Free kick for Lionsbridge. George Wyatt fortunate not to get called for a foul. Matarazzi and Hogan in a little game of catch between themselves. Now they'll involve Kirkwood as Hensley comes forward to try and spoil the fun. Chested along and is straight to Christalis. Christos. And the Eagles have it. Quickly moving out towards the sideline is Cornish. This through a pair of defenders before it's headed all the way back to Levy by Swinehart. Brennen has it, surveys the field, thinks twice, three times about his options, takes the space that's given to him. Lionsbridge can't really afford to give up too much space up the field. They have a lead, but it's only just one goal. And Hogan yet to really be tested here this evening. Certainly don't want to give away too many chances, especially they have a bit of a reputation for giving away fouls inside their own half. Donkey trying to shut down Gravekamp. Pass out to Swinehart on the far side. Kirkwood keeps this one in play. Rowe boots it up the line for Yonke. Yonke gets it over to Cornish now. Those two linked up. Over to find Faye. On the far sideline. Up for Yonke. He's offside yet again. Another offsides call going against Lionsbridge. Yonke just getting a bit too eager. Try and go in behind the back line. Charlotte taking their time. Still being very controlled and disciplined with the ball. Not taking too many dangerous chances as that ball goes up for Hensley. Knocked out of play by Rowe. So a throw-in comes up. And Gibisa still with the ball, booted away by Hall. Horn has tried to control it. Skips away from him. Charlotte has possession now. Herbalo's pass is redirected. Still in possession over on the far side. Bennett trying to close this angle down. It's Rowe who heads it away. Good touch by Christalis. A throw-in coming up. Now Rowe having a seat as that cross got whipped in and took it right off the side of his head. So he's going to just take a bit of time. The players head over towards the sideline for the hydration break here in the 74th minute. I'll take a brief pause from the action. The players make their way over the sidelines, reassess the game plans. Rowe gets twice over. We'll see if there's a substitute coming on for him as he's Foley is making his way over with one of the athletic trainers. Here in the Lionsbridge campus. Probably hear, sounds a lot like defend, defend, defend. And just don't give away a foul. Like, cut off those passing lanes, making sure that you're playing smart defense. Instead of diving into challenges, that's certainly a big way on how Charlotte can get back into this game. Over on the other side of things, with Charlotte, I think it's just keep on doing what they've been doing. Is they've had a really solid game plan throughout these first 75 minutes. Now with 15 minutes left here in this Friday night faceoff. Yeah, the game plan has just been really solid. They've been putting the pressure on Lionsbridge, especially here in the second 45 minutes. Unfortunately for them, they just don't have... anything to show for it on the scoreboard. Certainly not the lack of trying, though. Swinehart has had a couple good chances from the corner. And Givisa as well from the run of play. Now here with another throw-in, and Givisa gets fed in past the defense. It is touch or tracing, and it rolls out over the end line. Goal kick for Lionsbridge. Logan, currently sitting on a yellow card, urges his team to push forward. As for Lionsbridge, when they get the ball going forward, I certainly think they want to completely flush it out of their own half. As Givisa gets a step on Faye, he goes down. And a yellow card gets handed out. That might be to Rowe. It is a card for Lionsbridge as with another foul as Hall gets brought down. Both sides at five, at least five fouls and a half. The Eagles just had their fifth, Lionsbridge their sixth. Matarazzi restarts the play over to Kirkwood. The throwing coming up for the Eagles. Settled down by Gravekamp. Donkey trying to take advantage of this opportunity. Not many jerseys following him, though. He works his way towards the sideline. Drops it back to Bennett. Now Salome. Salem. Towards the middle. His pass is knocked away. All tries to pick up the pieces. On the near sideline, instead Matarazzi goes back to Hogan. Kirkwood brings the ball up. Quite a bit of power behind it as he tries to send it over to Cornish. Knocked out of bounds by Erlinson. Hall. Wyatt, as a spectator, finally gets involved. Cornish again. A bit of trickery to keep the ball away from the defenders. Sends it to safe territory. Punched away by Levy as Hay was coming in for a header. Hay nearly gets dropped right back in and will get called for a foul. He'll have his hands out to stabilize himself, but in the process brings down defender number 24, Erlinson. He certainly has played a pivotal role for the Eagles here tonight. Dealt with Hatley all through the first half until Hatley switched sides, and then he was able to contain Cornish. Eagles win another throw-in. 80th minute. Time running out for Charlotte, but still a chance to get on the board as Charlotte sends a short pass to Erlinson. Give and go between the two of them. Gravekamp up the field. His short passing game is working wonders. Inside of the 18, Hall heads it up to Hogan. Just out of reach. That was Costales. That's a big stop for Lionsbridge. It's exactly the game plan that Charlotte has had all contest, nearly leading to a great chance. Short controlled passes. Kirkwood goes down. Play on from the official. Dropped back towards the top of the box. Hall able to clear the way to Cornish. Lionsbridge, another crisis averted as Bennett was able to pick it up inside his own half. Gets it over the row. Fay coming back towards the middle, trying to make a passing lane open for himself. Headed outside of the 18. Maddie Cornish. He's an addition to the Lionsbridge squad. Sends in a cross. Levy can't hang on to it. Game nearly being put to rest there. Had there been a better connection inside the box for Lionsbridge. Eagles have a player down. It's John. He's trying to stretch out his hamstring. Bennett taking this one up the field. He gets brought down. Play continues. Yonke has it on the edge of the box. Swinehart able to shut down his attack from distance. Saved by the goalkeeper. Good effort by Salem. Gets headed down the far sideline. Monkey Divisa. It's touched out of bounds as there's a couple players now just trying to stretch things out for both sides. Throw for Lionsbridge. Also John for Charlotte. Weston Blondell comes into the game for Harry Rowe. Also a substitution for the Eagles as well. We'll see who comes on to replace Elijah John. His name is Walter Gomez. Scott coming on to replace the Almeida as well. The three substitutions, one for Lionsbridge, two for the Eagles here in the 84th minute. The roster getting shuffled around just a little bit as Gomez tries to get in early. His first touch of the game. We'll have to wait a little while longer, though, as the ball makes its way over to Cornish. Into the attacking third. Inside the 18, firing off the shot. Leg saved by Levy. Did well to stick his foot out towards the near post to make that stop. There's Walter Gomez getting into the mix of things as his first touch. Gravekamp. Nice turn. We see Swinehart moving up the field. He's now positioned as a midfielder. probably just a forward now, as Eagles are trying to get everyone to go forward. Ball just barely rolls out over the end line for a goal kick. Swinehart, we saw him in that right back position all night long. Now with Scott coming into the game, Scott will take over there. The formation gets rearranged. Cornish on the end of it. Sends it outside to Blondell. Has Fay behind him. Gets a cross in. Held by Drennan. Dangerously though. He's able to get the ball out. Blondell trying to win it. Blondell gets called for the foul. He got tangled up. I believe that was Cristales. Free kick and quickly played out by the Eagles. Time winding down, 86th minute. Spot in the Eastern Conference semifinals on Sunday night. Coming out of this game, Swinehart. Plays a crossing, too low, and it's picked off by Lionsbridge. Bennett, clever turn. Heading towards the middle of the field. He gets fouled by Carvalho. Carvalho saying to the referee, is just a mix-up between legs. Legs getting tangled. All trying to urge the home fans on. Matrazzi plays it over to Wyatt. Now the pressure comes. Yonke gets pulled to the ground by Drennan. That's probably the first and only mistake really that Drennan has made defensively here tonight. He's had himself quite a stellar game. Free kick from Kirkwood to Blondell. Trying to find Kirkwood. By number 24, Olinson. Cornish inside the box. This would pass off to Kirkwood. Blondell, left-footed effort. Sliding stop by Drennan. Gets the ball out over to Fay. Tries to reintroduce it and gives it away instead. Played up by Gomez. Hogan well outside of his line. Ball out of play. Hogan outside of his box finally gets set. Swinehart trying to push forward. Erlinson along the sideline. Carvalho, can he get across it? Too many blue jerseys. He's denied. This one played up to Yonke. Sliding effort from Yonke. Thought that maybe that would be his best bet to try and get the ball. Instead, it's picked up by the Eagles. Matarazzi boots it down the field to Levy. He controls it. Scott. Brought up now by Erlinson. Has Swinehart on his left. Tries to play it to Carvalho down towards the corner. Swinehart making a move inside the box now. Hall trying to shut Carvalho down. Lionsbridge can't give away a foul here. This far inside their own territory. They need to play smart defensively. Inside the 18, it's Hensley. Finding a little bit of space, firing a shot up and over for a goal kick. Good pressure coming from Charlotte though. Time just winding down a little bit more and more each time. Hogan has to let this ball fly pretty soon. As we await the stoppage time announcement, Swinehart moving towards the middle of the field. That pass out past Yonke. And Gibisa pushed away by Hogan. it's out towards the corner. A fourth corner kick coming up here in this half for Charlotte. Carballo makes his way to the corner. He'll be the one to take this. Anguilisa down on the far side of the field. Pinballs around, top of the box. Fires from distance. Sent away by Hall. Another corner coming up. Finally, it gets stopped. The play. As we approach stoppage time on Gubisa. Down on the far side of the field. Almost right in front of his bench. To hold on to the back of his left leg. He gets helped up by the trainers. Jordan Rebson comes on to it. Place him. Players, get ready for this next corner. Coming up. In 3 minutes of stoppage time. The ball finds its way towards the back. Back post. And the center back down is Cristales. Hogsman. Cristales across in. Grabbed by Hogan. And that's a big save for him. Lionsbridge making their way up the field. They'll roll it out. Kirkwood has it. He really just swings his foot through this one. Pick up the volume and throws the home side on to the second round of the playoffs. Carballo trying to spoil the party. Across inside the middle for Gomez. It's scooped up by goalkeeper Hogan. Sideline for a substitution. And amongst the game is Don Foster, another defender. Might not matter too much at this point, though, depending on how far this kick from Hogan goes. Foster trying to get stuck in things. Gustavus out along the sideline. It's a throw in for Lionsbridge. Jalon with the throw to Yonke down towards the corner. Getting stuck in with the defenders. He gets called for a foul, does Yonke. Deep inside Eagles territory. Levy trying to move quickly. Takes this one well up the field. Over the head of Kirkwood. Carballo has it. And the third time whistle sounds. Carballo falls to the ground just after the final whistle. Players immediately rushing over. It was just a foul. Lionsbridge thought they had it. It was just a free kick. Hogan sends it up to Yonke. Settled down by Hall. Hall tries to find a little bit of space with Bennett. Jalon. Bring it over towards the sideline. Knocked out of bounds by Scott. Waters with the throw in inside Charlotte territory. It looks like the home side will be moving on to the second round of the playoffs. A date with NC Fusion on Sunday night. Goal kick coming up. Levy, possibly the last chance for Charlotte. Erlinson bringing the ball up the field himself. Blondell trying to take it away. He drops back. Scott throws it up and overshoots Carvalho. Going for Lionsbridge. Hogan and Hall both pointing to just send the ball down the line. Looked up and out of play by Fay. Could that have been a mistake? This one towards Materazzi. Knocked out of bounds. It'll be a throw-in. Erlinson. Carvalho has it. He gets dispossessed. The final whistle sounds. Lionsbridge advances to the second round of the Eastern Conference semifinals. A hard fight game. The Bridge come out on top by a score of 1-0 against the chisel score of the 52nd. What a game from start to finish between these two sides. Great match from the Charlotte Eagles. They certainly put everything on the line against Lionsbridge. Took them to the full 90 minutes. They can whistle the whistle. The Charlotte Eagles defense has been quite strong. In the end, it just wasn't quite strong enough. It's just one goal between these two teams. Chisel in the 52nd minute. His third attempt to put it past Levy. Finally successful. Certainly, Eagles should be walking away with their heads held high after this game. They certainly brought the fight to the Bridge in enemy territory and hung with them until the very end. Give a special mention to a couple of Eagles players, Bryce Swinehart, Theo Drennan, as well as Joshua Erlinson, making things as difficult as possible for Lionsbridge. They played a phenomenal game defensively, and then Swinehart, even at the end, going up on the attack. It just wasn't in the cards for them. They closed their season. An overall record of 9-2-4. 9-3-3. Lionsbridge advances to the Eastern Conference semifinals with a record of 10-2-1. And that will be played here at TowneBank Stadium Sunday night at 7 o'clock. LionsbridgeFC.com/tickets to secure your spot here at TowneBank Stadium. And a big emotional win for Lionsbridge. So much for tuning in to tonight's matchup between the Eagles and Lionsbridge FC. And we hope you'll join us again here at TowneBank Stadium on Sunday night when North Carolina Fusion takes on Lionsbridge for a chance to win the Eastern Conference. All of us here at TowneBank Stadium, I have been and will continue to be Austin Urch. We will see you next time. Oh, 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 oh.